This is BBC Television from London. Diana, Princess of Wales, has died after...
You've got mail.
America Online.
After 156 years of British rule, China's
presidential inauguration of the 20th century. Let us lift our eyes...
Now, if you want to send it saying that the woman should face criminal prosecution, but she shouldn't have...
My fellow citizens, I stand here today humbled, grateful for the trust you've bestowed.
Napster is my first Windows application.
iPhone is a revolutionary product and combines three products into one. It's a great mobile.
I think people have become a lot more daring.
Shoppers, customers have become so much more sophisticated.
People that shop online and shop in stores and who know about fashion, and everyone's so much more educated now.
Online technology is sort of tapping into that quite tribal instinct that guys have.
People aren't really prepared to just buy into some big kind of faceless idea anymore. They want to feel that they're being targeted. That's just the mantra of our age, really, isn't it?
Basically, fashion designers are celebrities now. They're stars. We're in a culture where I think combine the celebrity aspect with the fashion aspect, and what could be sexier, more interesting than a fashion designer?
I'm here with Diane, and she's a fashion designer.
I am what?
Are you a fashion designer?
I am a fashion designer.
Well, I think like everything else, fashion, I think the way people engage with fashion has become a kind of a community. There's a kind of community element. People find, like, to link up with other people who like the same kind of looks, and it's a kind of a way of finding people who they feel comfortable with, and then they will take recommendations from them. I mean, I know the Facebook group kind of idea.
You know, whether it's communities that are gathered around websites that talk about a certain type of music or a certain type of design or a certain type of vintage jeans or denim or, you know, whatever it might be. I think that websites and the whole sort of online aspect, you know, it really chimes with what guys are about.
People pass links around. People pass around, you know, products that they want to buy. People see pictures of people wearing things, whether it's on Sartorialist or Grand Soirée or all these other street style, you know, sites. It's like, you know, they can price compare and stuff, and they just have more material available to them. Your product can immediately be out there.
I think in general, I mean, we can say that the sort of resonance of fashion in society overall seems, an interest in fashion seems to be growing and growing and growing. So people are aware of many brands and looks. But what the web has done is, like, Net-a-Porter can launch a designer because they can be anywhere. They can be in Singapore and doing fantastic work. I mean, it doesn't matter where they are, the designer is, and it doesn't matter where the customer is.
Fashion shows, if you used to wait for a fashion show and, you know, then the photographs would be released and so on. Now, of course, everybody's photographing it and it's up on the internet before the fashion show's finished.
This idea that 1 second after a runway show happens, anybody in the world can see that show and know what the trends are themselves. They don't have to wait for anybody to tell them. They don't have to wait for magazines, and proliferation of blogs. You know, it's not just fashion magazines dictating what the trends are or what people should be wearing or how they should be wearing them. You know, now it's, you know, the person living next door to you who's got a fashion blog.
I had quite a funny experience at the Burberry fashion show because Burberry flew over like 20 most influential fashion bloggers in the world and put them up in London and put them all in the front row of their show. And which is kind of just, you know, unheard of, even 6 months ago, let alone in, you know, 5 years ago. And they, you know, they really do treat them very well. So they are a new kind of fashion royalty. I said to the PR, because I had to file news on for the paper straight afterwards, And I said, is there going to be somewhere at the show, at the venue, where I can go and sit with my laptop? And they said, oh yeah, yeah, there's a blog suite, so you know, you come there. And I went there and I filed my copy, and we were in this little room, and it was kind of, they were just so, they can't do enough, the bloggers, you know, they had champagne waiters, and I filed my copy, and then I turned around and I saw all the celebrities who'd been in the show all sitting in this room, because they'd obviously just seen like a glass screened off room with champagne waiters. They just assumed it was a VIP room. So they're all sitting there in the blog suite with like me and all the other little geeks on our laptops. It's hilarious. So yeah, I mean, it's just, it's been a real sudden change in the industry around blogging.
I can't underestimate the importance of H&M and Zara. I think what they did, I mean, they've been around for a long time, but they started getting attention, let's say, maybe 10 years ago. I started being more aware of it. And I think that's about the time when there seemed to be no middle, like contemporary just didn't seem to exist at all. So there was really high fashion, and it kept getting more and more expensive and more luxurious. And then the middle market just seemed to disappear. If it didn't disappear, it just didn't seem that relevant or trend driven. And then here's H&M. And just think, if you're a teenager and you're going on a date, you can spend $20 and have a date dress. And if you don't wear it again, it doesn't really matter.
That's a real problem for designers. Who work really hard and put out these collections and come up with these ideas, and then 1 second after they show it on the runway, it's on style.com, and it's there for everybody to knock off. So on the one hand, it's really tough for designers. On the other hand, it's great for consumers.
まずブランド品ということにも、今の20前後の子たちって実はあんまり興味がないんだろうなと思うんですよ。大手のブランドさんたちもその辺のニュージェネレーションのゲットをどうしたらいいかっていうことをなんかこう非常にお考えだったりとかすると思うので、あとその世の中の選択がどんどんもっと増えてきているから、ブランドだけではなくてファストファッションというかファストプライスファッションなんかもどんどん増えてきて、
I mean, you look at H&M and the ones they've done with Stella McCartney, the ones they've done that were really properly designed have done really well. The ones they've done with Madonna, who's not a designer, actually nobody was interested. It's not just a celebrity name here. People do actually want the Karl Lagerfeld, the Stella McCartney, and I think the high street have been surprised by how sophisticated people are in what they want.
I think the brand's expansion is now getting bigger. I think, because 有比如像 H&M 或者说是像 Zara、优衣库这样的品牌，就是快速消费类品牌。如果说影响北京或上海这一两年最厉害的一个品牌，应该算是优衣库或者还和 H&M。对，我觉得首先你可以从那儿找到非常多 basic 的东西，很基本，它很容易搭配。你会觉得那个他的审美会和大多数潮流上接近，但又不是过分前卫，对。然后他的衣服能解决你生活中所有你要应付的场合，或者说是你可能会发生在你的生活中的所有的场景。
日本は今10代20代の女の子のクリエイターというかデザイナー。割とこう身近に洋服が作れるっていう土壌がすごく発達していて、もう世界の最先端のメゾンのいいところとロープライスのブランドのいいところと日本人の体型をすごい熟知してこうやったらスタイルがよく見えるよっていう。
The days of designer versus high street are over. The two are kind of in it together, and if either of them are going to survive, then they kind of have to work together.
Things that men do differently now, and I think that a lot of it comes down to this sort of era of the metrosexual, which was actually a very difficult time for a lot of guys, because they were suddenly spat out of this sort of alpha male era that had run for a long time and had been absolutely heralded in the era of the lads mags in the UK, which was, you know, hugely influential period of publishing with magazines like Loaded and FHM when they were at their prime. But I think having come through those sort of different, quite consecutive eras, guys have sort of taken elements of all of it, of all of it. So, you know, people are more comfortable spending £40, £50 on a haircut, or, you know, will, you know, you go into most guys' bathrooms and there will be product on the shelves that would not have been there 15, 20 years ago.
And it is now totally acceptable for men to shop and be interested in clothes and be interested in fashion, and I think you can really see that when you walk down the street.
Customers have become so much more sophisticated too. Shoppers know that there are different weights, that there are, you know, 1,000 different necklines, that, you know, I'm somebody who only likes a hip length t-shirt, I'm somebody who only likes, you know, a waist length t-shirt, you know, it's just, I think the demand for that variety is really has really changed.
10年前と今では社会人のお洋服に対する考え方が若干変わったのかなと思います。例えば以前でしたらリクルートスーツだったりとするものがかなりの形で限定されていたと思うんですが、その辺の幅が広がったと思うんですよ。なので、まあ通勤着にも使えプラス、まあ、プライベートのデートにも着られる洋服っていうのをの幅が広がったので、会社だけっていう考え方ではないのかなと思います。
I think if you take an overview of how people dress to work, it has just become incredibly much more casual. I think the whole idea of workwear as a kind of very distinct element that 10 years ago, most, you know, a lot of people had a kind of a work wardrobe that was almost like you used to have your school uniform. You know, it was so separate from the rest of your clothes. And for a lot of people, that's not relevant. I mean, obviously, if you're a nurse or a, you know, traffic policeman or something, then that's still very much the way it works. But it's kind of the new power dressing really involves showing that you kind of have a bit of a clue about fashion, I think.